drama over here supporting the mural. Homies got the mural going back up. They try to take this away from us. Mayor Gavin Newsom put the fence away to take away our hood and try to stop the violence. But you know that ain't gonna stop shit. It's just wasting taxpayers' money. They took our wall away, took our history away, took our culture away. So we had to put it back up, basically, and show solidarity within our hood. We got all the homies over here, all the females, all the homeboys, you know what I mean, representing the mission and what our culture is. It's about love and respect and unity.
I know you're responsible for the ones that's putting the graffiti, you know, the art of the murals back up on the wall, because, you know, a lot of people thought when they tore down the wall that there was going to be no more murals, and they were really taking a lot away from the Mission District. Now, how were you able to do that?
So we painted the wall like in 2000, like 7 years ago, and because so many people participated in helping make the wall possible, you know, people put their ideas, their energy into it, and we had a little barbecue just like this. That wall got respected, you know what I'm saying? Like, people didn't tag on it, they didn't disrespect it. It was up for a long time, people took care of it. So we feel like the same thing right now. We went to the city and told them that if they really want to prevent violence in the neighborhood, this fence ain't gonna help. They want to prevent violence in the neighborhood, they need to invest in us, give us some resources so that we can help our people, so that we can do positive stuff.
So who did you talk to?
We went to the Arts Commission and we got it approved. We went to the Department of Public Works, we went to the Parking Authority.
So it was a few different people you had to talk to in the city. To make it happen. And what's their names? Do you know their names? Who's the biggest person that helped you out to make this happen?
The biggest persons that helped out to make this happen are the young people that all participated in getting the images together, organizing, the homies that are barbecuing, the homies that brought their cars out so we could have a sound system. Like, all the folks from the neighborhood that have come out and helped paint, even the little kids.
That's great.
All the little kids been getting down.
So how long you think this project's gonna take?
Little kids having fun out here.
So how long do you think this is going to take?
So we've been out here all day yesterday and all day today, and then we're just going to touch up the rest of the wall, fix it up this week. So, I mean, it's hopefully it'll be done by the end of the week.
So about a week, 7 days? Well, you know, got a lot of respect for you. I'm sure a lot of people love that you made this happen, because
yeah.
I'm sure you were the voice to speak on it.
It's all love, bro.
You know what I'm saying? And you found the ways and technique. It's all about technique, right, on how you're going to do it. It's like they're doing the gang injunction. How do you feel about that?
You know what I'm saying? It's like we all learn hustling skills some way, and I'm just trying to use those hustling skills with some positivity. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to use those hustling skills in a legit way, and not be like trying to, you know what I'm saying, come up on some people or like sell some poison to get some money. Like, I'll find other ways to get money and provide resources for the people. And right now what they're trying to do with the gang injunctions is they're trying to make it so that, like, the block is, you know, on lockdown. They're trying to make it so that, like, certain people don't feel comfortable being out on the street, and that's not going to fix nothing. Like, if you really want to fix some violence, like, we got to work with these young people, you know what I'm saying? Like, they can throw the word gang member around the same way they throw around the word terrorist, feel me? Like, just to make people scared. Like, every culture has gangs. Every culture has street organizations that come together. It's just the difference is the Boy Scouts and the Girl Scouts, they got money.
Right.
Our crews, we ain't got no resources. So sometimes we have to revert to, like, you know, some illegal activity. And what we're trying to do is just put some positivity for our people out there.
So what is, can you tell me?
She painting on me.
You're supposed to paint on the wall.
I'm Nancy Feely. I work at Homies Organizing, the mission to empower youth. And y'all are watching Treal TV Round 2, Thizz Latin.